Hey everyone, I'm Kano from Liquipedia, and today I'll be going through how we upload images on Liquipedia that you can use all across our wiki. Basically, as you may know, Liquipedia uses a bunch of images for team logos, player pictures, team photos, game-related content. Basically, everything just falls under images, and we have a specific place where we upload these. And once you've uploaded these, you can use them all across Liquipedia by calling them by their file name and inserting them into templates. As you can see on the player page, you'll see there's a team logo already there, there's a player photo, there's a gallery section with more photos down here. The same goes for a character page, like for example in Deadlock where we have the character, icons they use on the abilities, more icons, gallery sections. There's a bunch of different ways we can use images. So what's good to know is that these are hosted in a central place, which you can find on a thing we call the Commons Wiki, which if you go to main wiki, and usually at the bottom, you can recognize by the folder little here, and there's a thing called the Commons. Here you can see, for example, the recent uploads people have done. There's a couple of portal links, but if you specifically want to upload something, you will go directly to the upload portal. Do make sure if you want to upload something, check the top right if you're logged in. If you are, you can immediately start uploading, and then we will head into the upload page. I will also open the file standards guides because it's something I'll quickly go over, and the same for the copyright repository, so I'll get to that in a bit. So in this case, we go to upload. You'll be great with it. Basically a lot of, please be warned, please pay attention to these things because it's quite important. And so for example, if you upload team logos, refer to this file standards guide, which I'll get into. Make sure that the license information is correct because we have to deal with permissions. Since Liquipedia runs ads, we can't fall under like public domain and that kind of stuff. We basically have to ask for team logos. This falls under fair use. But if you're using images taken by a photographer or owned by an organization, you will likely need permission. So yeah, there's also basically a quick little how-to here. Like, hey, make sure you choose your file. Make sure you pick a good name. If you obviously state where you got the image from, yada yada. So basically, if you want to upload something, this is the most important part, the source file section. In here, you will have your option to choose a file, which will immediately open your file explorer. So let's say I want to do this logo. It already exists on a wiki, so it will warn me if it's already there or if it shares a name. But here's what I've selected. You can also do a source URL, but I've never used this personally. I usually just download and then make sure my files are up to the standards. It's in Dutch here, but on your device, it will be in whatever your browser settings are set to. So then we get to the second most important, which is the file description. After selecting your image, first off, you will be giving it a file name. Obviously, what we like to do is make sure it's concise and it contains what's in the image. For logo specifically, we have a guide on how to name your logo files, because there's ways that the file name interprets things across the wiki. And then we have the summary, and this is very important where we fill in our information about the file. So featured is usually what page is it featured on. For logos, it's not this important, but you could, for example, say Nemesis, it's featured on the Nemesis page. This is, for example, a team logo that's only in Apex Legends, so we could fill this in. And then if this is filled in, it will automatically link to the Nemesis page in its file description on the Apex Legends wiki. You can put a description here like the Nemesis team logo. If it's a player, you could say it's, let's say, player X at the X Games or whatever. This is all not too important. It's just nice because it helps with searchability if you're using the search function. Important here is the license. There's a multitude of licenses we use. And for a logo, you can typically use fair use logo. This implies that because it's a logo, we can use it under fair use, and it marks us that it is a team logo or a logo for an event. And that's good for us because this is the license you'll be using for logos. The other one that you'll likely use is permission, which you just write as this, permission. In this case, it means that we have gained permission specifically to use the image in question. This applies again to photos. I'll repeat this often, but it's very important. And there's other things you can fill out. If it's photo taken a specific event, you can enter the tournament name, for example. You can fill in the date that the image got taken. And especially with permissions, you often want to write down, hey, who took the picture, who owns the picture. This is sometimes different. Sometimes events or tournaments hire photographers, which means the tournament organizer owns the pictures, but obviously the photographer took the picture. You can add notes here, and there's a source which you can link to, like, hey, this is where you got the image from. And the note is, I'll get a bit more into details, but people often leave here like, hey, where did we gain the permission? If you fill out the license wrong, what will happen is, there's not an example here, but there will be a red border around the image that only logged in users can see, which is a warning like, hey, there's not a proper license added to this file. Please, if you don't remove this and add a license, the image will be removed from the wiki. So going back into this, if I would press upload now, it would warn me like, hey, this file obviously already exists. We can, for example, check out this file. For example, if we search it and we go back, we can leave this page. We have the file here. If I press edit, I've only filled in fair use logo because it's just a logo. So yeah, that's basically how to deal with logos. So now let's first head into the file standard guide, since that's, again, primarily for logos. There's a bit of a change log at the top, how we do this, but it's basically tournament team logos. They follow basically the same procedure. There's some recommendation about like sizes, but most importantly, the logo is usually a PNG type file. You could also technically use WebP, but PNG is generally preferred at the moment. Make sure that there's no white space. So for example, there's no extra floating space. Like for example, on this one, you see that there's a bit more room. You basically want the logo to touch the edges of the file. You don't wanna, ideally we don't use banners. We just want the clean PNG logo. For icons, it's tournament icons, it's basically the same, it's like a logo. So you can also go down here, this applies for team logos, and you can see, hey, there's team logos that are have a dark background or a light background. There's different ways to handle this, but again, make sure there's no white space, make sure obviously, ideally the quality is good. And then we get to the file naming, which is very important here. It's explained here. Basically, what this says, please write the full team name, so Team Liquid, for example. And then there's the identifier for the theme, which is either all mode, dark mode, or light mode. That's what the file ends on, because this will automatically indicate like, hey, this logo is meant for the dark background, because sometimes teams have two variants of the logo. All mode implies it works for both backgrounds, so you don't have to upload two logos. And then if there's two logos version as well, where there's text at the bottom, for example, with the Team Liquid logo here, you can add full to the file name. So it's full all mode. And then you can also upload all mode, because the full one will be used on the team page, whereas this will be used across the wiki on team templates. Another thing is teams often update their logos. So we'd use an identifier of the year of when this logo was changed. So like Team Liquid 2022 or 2020 is basically what's being done. There's a couple of like legacy images that will likely like use these file types. Please don't use them. Try to stick to these examples. Now the other one, player photos. There's not too many guidelines here. Just make sure, like, obviously the player is clearly in frame. Here's some examples. There's basically, as long as it's proper, fits the wiki, feel free to use it. But again, remember the copyright guide very much applies to this. So yeah, heading into the copyrights repository. Let's say I wanted to upload an image. We have a thing called the copyrights repository. This is a list of a bunch of organizations or photographers or teams that have given us general permission to use anything they upload or from a specific album. So if you want to upload something, check here if we already have permission, because that will just make it a lot easier. What I like to do sometimes is just press Ctrl F, type League of or LOL Esports, for example. Here we have their permission, specifically from their Flickr album. And here you can see more like previously filled in templates for the permission. So here you can see, you can basically copy paste this into the file you wanted to upload. And then you can see game, League of Legends, featured, you fill in like which player is there, same for the event, description, yada yada. And then this bottom part is like copyright, Riot Games owns this, note, hey, Riot Games has given Liquipedia permission to use the images from their page, in this case, the Flickr album, please make note of this. So the same goes for a bunch of these. Sometimes they want you to specifically credit the photographer. Sometimes like, hey, you can't crop the images, or you can not alter. You must make sure the watermark is always on them. There's a bunch of different variables here. But yeah, if you have a picture that someone sent to you and you got their permission and it's not listed here, what you can also do, tell the owner of the picture to email photos@liquipedia.net. It will send us an email to the Liquipedia employee team to their inbox, and we will forward it to our Discord so that people know, hey, we have permission for this image. Please use this. Yeah, this is very important because let's say we upload something and we didn't have permission, we then obviously could get complaints or people might want to have the image taken down. If there is an email, we can always backtrack this and be like, hey, look, we've gained permission to use this. That's why it's important. So let's say you've uploaded your image. How can I now use it? Heading into this player page, for example, if you want to change something in the info box, you would press edit here and there's the image is field. In which case you can head file, for example, this is the file name that the file got uploaded under. Just enter it here, it will appear in the info box. The same goes for team pages or tournament pages. It will have the image field in the info box. If you have a gallery section, for example, here, there's a bit of a hover over effect. You can press edit here on the gallery. There's a bit of code that starts the gallery. So gallery mode, packed, hover, height, that kind of stuff. And then you will list the image as here, and then there's a separator to actually include the hover text. And there's a lot of other ways that images can be included on a page. But this is generally what you'll generally be doing. For team logos, there's another thing called the team templates. There's another specific guide here, but you can then insert the file name here. I'd rather link you to the full team templates guide because it's a whole beast of its own. But yeah. So that, in short, is how to upload files. I think as I mentioned here, fair use logo is your best friend for logos. Permission is very much what you need for any photographs that are owned by another entity that would need to give us permission. There's other ones, obviously, like there's things that are public domain, so we could use, we have a thing for that. There's Blizzard, for example, has a specific license that we can use for game assets. Just make sure to fully check this. As I mentioned, the file standards guide is your other best friend, how to deal with logos. The copyright repository will help you find what the actual permissions are. So please make sure to both check those pages out. And I hope this helped with uploading.